It was, I remember at the end of my 20s, I'm getting to be 27, 28, 29, and I'm getting this feeling like, you know, I spent all that money on that school. I mean, I like landscape construction. I was in great shape, but I'm like, I should really do something. I'm pretty good. I started to draw, and the landscape guys are all looking, and I'm drawing, they're going over to my pad and looking, and I had this like epiphany, like, you know, you got to do something with this art. You're getting to be 30. Maybe you can't swing a pickaxe all your life, you know? And, but I did have an idea, like, you got to have a day job. I wonder if I got that from my either, like my, I think from my mom, because she was always working, you know, get a job. And, she was right, you know, in a way, you know. But that's when I decided and just started covering all my bases. I went back to the Kubert School. Sure enough, Kubert School, DC Comics, when they need somebody in a bullpen, they go to the Kubert School because it was a lot of lettering fixes and stuff like that. There ain't a lot of places that teach that. And the Kubert School excelled in teaching the guys lettering and all different aspects of comics. So they would go there. And sure enough, I walked in. I said, you guys got anything? I got to, you know, get my portfolio together. I'm thinking, I'm getting serious. I'm getting to be 30 years old. I got to do something. And they said, yeah, DC should be, they're looking for a guy. They'll probably, we'll give you a call in a couple months. And then they set it up. They set up the interview up in the offices. They were at 1300 back then. That was right after it came off that Batman movie with Prince and Kim Basinger and all that. The offices were great. They were really, it was this colorful place. And it was funny. I saw my future boss walk by and he said, I got to interview this guy. Oh man, this bum, you know, or something. He didn't say it that bad, but he definitely sounded like, oh man, I got another interview. And he goes, and I say, uh-oh, I wonder, and I'm sitting there ready to get interviewed. But, yeah, they brought me back. And so how that rolled into, like, I had been up there 3 years. I got the job. That was amazing. Even my friends were like, you ain't going to get that job. Everybody's going up for that job. Don't get your hopes up. And sure enough, they said I was the only guy who talked. Which I couldn't, I remember I got up, it was the 23rd floor. I'd never been on a 23rd floor of a place. I went over to the window, wow, you guys, oh. And I got hired up there. I was there for about 3 years. Actually, bullpen, I'm moving balloons. Move the balloon over a quarter of an inch. I was basically a glorified Xerox. I had some ability, like I could draw a light bulb with a face in it if they needed some storytelling element like that. Some stuff got a little more advanced like that, but a lot of times it's fixing lettering correction, and you weren't going to go far, you know, and they weren't paying the big bucks. It was a fun place to work. You had good benefits up there. And that was a tough place, the bullpen. I think I learned a lot. And like I said, you're just seeing, like, you know, airbrushed Brian Boland cover come in or something like that. Or you're seeing, I remember they brought in the Dark Knight cover with Batman ways like this, you know, and everybody, you got it. That was the one piece, like, nobody got to touch it except for the boss and stuff like that. But I really got a, I was right up there with the pros, seeing all that and stuff. By the way, I was trying, I also got a hold of, like, Fantagraphics, and they said, wait, this is right when I was getting the interview at DC. They said, we don't really like this part, but we got this Eros line. You could do these nudie comics for us. So I was drawing a nudie comic, and it all, like, I got the DC job and was drawing the nudie comic at the same time, which I wasn't so comfortable with, you know? But that was actually my first, like, oh my God, I got to do 23 pages of comic book continuity here, you know? It wasn't like 3 pages. Joe Kubert School always had you doing 3, which was cool. But, that was my first published work, and they liked them. It actually did pretty good, you know. And it got me to the challenge of getting 23 pages done, written. And it was goofy. I had to do it goofy. But, like, less and less sex was getting into it. And they were like, we need more penetration. And I was, and I drifted from that. And by, like, 3 years up at the Kubert School, you should know, you're in the city. So I'd be out having a cigarette. I bump into somebody, hey, oh, I work on an online web magazine up here. We need illustrations. What's your, and I'd show them my stuff, and they, wow, come on up. You can get, and I started to get little jobs like that until they started to cover my rent, you know, and I'm living up here. I'm 2 hours out of the city, so it was like 12 hours a day on the road, you know, four of it in travel. And I'm seeing freelance coming in that's like paying my rent in like one job, and I just got the faith to like get out of there and go on my own, you know. The way I was figuring, I was like, man, if I could develop like five of these, I'd be killing it, you know. So I'm a cautious, you know, I'm cautious with my risks, and so it just seemed like the natural way to go, and that's how I did it, and ever since then we've been hustling, you know.